So the question here is like construct an hyperbola. So it is clearly mentioned that we are going to construct a hyperbola whose distance from the directrix and vertex is 24 mm. So your what is the rotation, sir, for directrix to vertex what we had? So what are the data which are available at this problem? What is the notation for directrix we are following? What is the notation for vertex we are following?
EMV, sir.
This directrix is given as E and vertex is given as V. Sorry.
VE is equal to 24.
Yes, sir. VE is equal to 24 mm. Then the other data we have is
VF by
small.
VE is equal to 4 by 3.
Small e is 4 by 3, or that is your VF by VE. We are going to construct an hyperbola. So as the construction procedure remains the same, so we are going to start with the vertical line, your directrix, then your major axis. So this is my location for E. Now I'm going to locate V and F. How to locate? We have clearly this dimension. Vertex to your directrix is given as 24 mm. So at a distance of 25 mm, you can locate the point V, right? This distance is 24 mm. So how to locate the point of F? Now we need to locate the point of F. How to locate the point of F? Where it should be coming?
After 32 mm from V, sir.
Okay, that is right, sir. Why it is 32 mm? Can you explain that?
Sir, VF is equal to 4VE by 3, sir. So it is equal to 4 into 24 by 3, sir. Then
Yes,
in
sir, that is
we
right.
get 32.
Yes, sir, we have this distance. Okay, so VF by VE is 4 by 3. So we need to find out the value for vertex to focus distance. So in this case, vertex to focus distance will be 4 by third of your PE. When you move to the other side, it will be in multiplication sign. So VE distance is given as 24 mm. So when I substitute that, we can get the value for VF as
32, sir.
32 mm. So at a distance of 32 mm, I'm going to locate my F. Sir, whether this is really clear here? This is the major step that will be like you are prone to your errors here. If there is any error in location of V and F, your curve will be entirely wrong. So make sure that your location of E, P, and F should be as intended. Don't construct somewhere else. It should be as intended here. So, sir, whether is this clear? How to locate E, P, and F?
Yes, sir.
Yes, that is all. You can proceed. The other thing is like similar to geometry, right? It is just steps. So, I am going to construct one vertical line, then your major axis. Location of E, that is your location. We have V now. V is at a distance of 24 mm. Then at a distance of 32 mm from V, I'm going to locate the point F. So the next step is I'm going to construct one arc from V as center, VF as radius. It should meet at a vertical, that is your V dash. Next step, V dash, I'm going to construct one inclined line. What is the next step, sir? What to do next?
Draw parallel lines with equal distance.
Yes, you're going to draw vertical lines which are parallel to each other as well as equal distance to each other. So try to draw parallel lines. Again, it is not necessary that you should be so numbers, four numbers are from five numbers are applicable. You can have n number of lines, no problem. Then, what is the next step?
Marking it as 1 1 dash 2 2 dash.
Yes, a vertical line where it cuts your major axis, locate it as 1, 2, dash 3, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 corresponding numbers. The next step is you are going to mark the similar kind 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, where it cuts your inclined line, EV dash line. So that will be termed as 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash. So what is the next step now?
1 1 dash has radius and f as center, you want to cut an arc.
Yes sir, 1 1 dash has radius with f as center.
F as center.
You are going to cut an arc on line, okay, the first line. So with 1 1 dash as the radius, f as center, cut to an arc on the top as well as the bottom. Similarly, 2 2 dashes radius, f as center, second line. 3 3 dashes radius, f as center, third line. 4 4 dashes radius, f as center, fourth line. 5 5 dashes as radius, f as center, and it goes on. So we'll be having several number of points. So join these points in a freehand so that you'll be getting a curve. That curve, what is the curve here?
Hyperbola.
Yes, so you'll be getting an hyperbola. So it is again an open curve. Okay, only ellipse is a closed curve. All the parabola and hyperbola are open curve. We are not going to close that. Sir, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So the construction for ellipse, parabola, and hyperbola are the same. The location of E, V and F is going to change. That is going to change your entire curve itself. Okay. So, as I have said, we will go with one more step. That is, how to construct tangent and normal. In the same problem, you will be given with this statement also. Construct tangent normal for any point on the curve. It can be given with any point on the curve. Okay. So I will start with this one. So please listen here. So I'm going to take one point. So this is my point. You can choose any point on the curve. If the question is given as it can be any point on the curve, you can choose any point on the curve. It is not necessary that it should be given here. You can select. We will do it the other way. So that will be clear for you. So I'm going to take a point. Okay, so what we are going to do now is, so this is my point P. I'm going to draw tangent normal for the point P. First thing, you try to join your point P to F. Point F to point P. It should be a straight line. Please consider this as a straight line. So P and F, I'm going to join it as a straight line. Then I'm going to draw one perpendicular line for this line. It should be meeting your directrix. So these two lines should be perpendicular to each other. Then the next step is, this is perpendicular. The next step, I'm going to join this to your corresponding point P. So that will be a tangent for the point, and this will be your normal. This line is called as tangent and this line is called as normal. I will repeat the procedure. First step, what I'm going to do is choose a point P, then draw a straight line to focus, then draw perpendicular line to PF to meet at E dash on directrix. Then from E dash, draw a straight line to point P. That will be your tangent. Perpendicular to the tangent will be your normal. Okay. Sir, one more thing I need to say list. Only black colored portion in the entire diagram should be drawn using your HB pencils. All the others should be only drawn using your 2H pencils. Clear? So that is your entire construction. Your dimension should be marked, then your all dimensions are known. Sir, whether this is clear?
Yes,
how to
sir.
construct a hyperbola as well as how to construct tangent and normal for any curve. Tangent and normal for any curve is again common for all these three, ellipse, parabola and hyperbola. This is the same procedure for construction of tangent and normal. So try to make a note of this. And all the details which are in black alone should be coming using in HB pencils. All the others should be used in 2H pencils only. Kindly see to that your curve. Hyperbola, I have used it in HB pencil. Your dimensions, these arrows and your numbers and whatever the notations I am using, I have used HB pencils. All the others are should be 2H pencils. These lines or constructions which 2H pencils should not be visible to me. It should be visible only to you. So try to draw as light as possible. Clear? So that is how your diagram should be.
Sir, can you explain that tangent and normal part, sir?
Okay.
Thanks, sir.
Okay. First step is we are going to try to have one point, sir. You can have anywhere on the curve. It is not necessary that it should be coming exactly at 10 mm or 20 mm in front of something like that. You can take anywhere on the curve. Okay, so that is the first step. Next step, you are going to draw one line from your focus to the point P. So this is we are going to draw one line through focus. We have the point P located first, then I'm going to draw one line from P to F. Then next step, I'm going to go with a perpendicular line from F to your directrix. It should be a perpendicular line. It should be drawn from F to the point E dash. E dash is just notation. Okay, sir. First point P location, then from P you are going to construct a line to F, then from F you are going to draw a perpendicular line to your E, then from E dash I'm going to draw one more line which passes through the point P. So this is your tangent line and it should be again in your dark black color or your HB pencil. It should pass through the point P. Then I'm going to draw one more line. That line should be perpendicular to the tangent which we have drawn. So that is your normal. So we can notate with Is it clear how to construct tangent and normal?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
So we are going to locate the point P first. Then from P, I'm going to draw a straight line to the focus. Then I'm going to draw a perpendicular line to E dash from F. Then from E dash, I'm going to draw a line passing to the point P. That will be the tangent, and perpendicular to the tangent will be your normal. So again, your tangent, normal, and the corresponding curve should be in HP pencils. All the other on 2H pencils. So is that clear? So can you move to the next thing?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes.